Welcome to the queue. Wait a minute. This isn't World War I, 1914, Axis and Allies. But the map in the game that was supposed to end last weekend or this weekend on Friday did not. It is a stalemate, just like World War I. So my map that I had laid out and ready to go is buried under all this stuff. So I had to set up an auxiliary map over here. And it is the Lieutenant Dan map. That's right. It's a good one. So anyway, we're set up over here. And then when we clear off that other table, I'll move everything over. That should be painful. But here we are with Britain. They had 39. It is their turn one. Four on tech. And the remainder is seven infantry, artillery, and a fighter. And let's get going. Everyone pretty much is gone. We got Italy and Commonwealth and France left after this turn. So I want to mention first, before I start moving my combat moves, that you can find all the other turns, Germany, Russia, and Japan, and US, of course, in the playlist. So you can go on there, click on those turns, watch those, subscribe to those channels, and then, you know, set up the notifications so you can see when turns come out. And then when the war's over, you can go there and turn them off. So let's get on with some combat. We have to avenge our Navy. So we've got a fighter from Scotland. One, two, and he'll have three left. And then two fighters from London coming down. They have four left. And then a destroyer, because we have to have a destroyer to attack that sub. That is a battle there. We'll have a battle here in the Med. We're going to have a fighter from Gibraltar. One, two, three, and it'll have a movement of one left. And then this cruiser from C-Zone 91 comes over. With that naval base, and it will fight the destroyer there. All right, so the next battle is in Tobruk here, and we got a tank, three infantry, artillery, and a mech. So we've got coming in two infantry, one artillery, one tank, and then the mech from Egypt will drive across El Alamein and join the fight. Let's throw some planes in there. From Malta, we've got a fighter, one, two. He'll have two left. We'll have a tactical from Egypt, one, two, and he'll have two left. And then we'll have a tactical come off of this carrier, one, two, and he'll have two left as well. We're gonna designate one of these tacticals to target select this tank. So it will fire at a three, and this tactical will be at a four. The last battle will be here in Iraq. So we're going to have this cruiser come out of 98. One, two, three. For a bombard. I'm going to put it up there so I remember. Cruiser from 39. One, two. And then this transport's going to grab an artillery and an infantry out of India. One, two. And they will go in there. I do have a plane marker. That means this fighter from India. We'll go one, two, three, four, so it'll have one left. Those are the battles. Let's roll some dice. So up here, I wonder if I can widen that correctly. Nope. Man, always fails. All right, so we've got for Germany a one for its defense. Britain has a two. The destroyer and three fighters at three. So let's roll that. Let's see what we get. We got a cocked on that, but we did get three hits with the fighter, so it is dead and it is still. Doesn't take anything with it. All right. Gotta make a pile here for the destruction. All right, so let's slide down here to the south. Move the dice. All right, so with this naval battle, we can roll it all together. The Italian destroyer will be a two. We have a fighter and a cruiser at threes. And look at that again. So we got a hit. So the Italian destroyer is dead, but we'll re-roll that and it gets a hit. So we're going to lose that cruiser, which stinks, but we do get the destroyer and the transport. All right, so what is, oh, this will be the next battle. So we've got our three for the target select on the tank. We'll roll that first. And it is a hit, so good for me. Usually, I wouldn't say usually they fail, because you got a 50-50 chance. But it seems like more times than not it fails. But we had a game here Saturday, and I was defending in Russia, and I had six tanks and then a bunch of infantry and artillery in Bryansk. And it was a back and forth battle, and this was the third attack. Germany was coming back in, and they had six attack bombers, and they decided to target select all six of my tanks. And the only reason I'm telling this story is because they got all six hits, so which was devastating because then the rest of those twos went down really fast. All right, so let's get back to the battle. So we got the tank out of there with the target select. We have a tank for the British, a fighter, and a tactical that is boosted to a four. We've got an artillery, an infantry, and then we have a mech, and then an infantry. So let's see what we can do damage-wise. Two hits, so that's not very good. I guess if you include the target select, that was okay, I guess. All right, so they have two, three, four, five. Five twos for Italy. And, oh, dang. So we're going to lose our two infantry and our mechanized. And we probably should continue that attack since we've started it. So we got a two for the artillery. We got a tank. We have a tactical that did the target select, and then we have a tactical that is boosted by a fighter. Is that right? One, two, three, four, five. Yep, five dice. All right, so three hits, we're done. There's three. All right, so Italy is gone. Here is the question, though. Can we take it? Because they get three dice back at us. I am not losing a plane for Tobruk. Oh! Dang! So I lose my tank and artillery. That was painful. So the planes are still there with two, and I take that marker off. Italy gets to keep it. It's not worth anything, but all the units are gone, so that's what's important. All right, so the last battle is here in Iraq, and we are gonna have two targets, not two targets, two bombardments from the cruisers. Infantry, artillery, and a fighter at three. So we need two hits to clear it. And we only got two hits, and it's just the infantry artillery. All right. There is two infantry in Iraq, and they get one. So we'll lose that, and Britain will go up two for that. So that is the only battle that affects their income. So they'll go up to 41, and no one goes down because that was a Axis minor. Or pro-Axis, I should say, not a minor. All right, so let me get all this out of the way. We're going to do some non-coms. Is that right? Let me get these. Yeah, I don't see any more battles. All right, well, while we're over here, let's do India. India is going to swap the destroyer from 39 over to 37. The battleship from 37 will come to 39. Seemed like the right thing to do. Or is it? Yeah, it is. That's good enough. All right, so we've got our infantry here. We've got five left. We're going to send one to West India. And I think we'll leave those five there. We'll send these two from Burma to Shan State. Fighter will head back to India from Burma. Everything else stays the same. I am only doing Britain this turn, and then Italy goes, and then I do Commonwealth. So we have a fighter here that will land in Transjordan. These cruisers are no longer on land. All right, so we're going to move one infantry over. So what am I going to do here? Oh, you know what? This infantry in no. I think he's going to stay. I think we're going to leave. We're going to leave our infantry like that. I think we are. I think we'll just forget that move. Get rid of that. Our planes are landing here in Egypt. All three of them. And then this one here has one left, so it will go to Malta. All right. And then what will Malta do? Well, we're going to take this transport, come here, grab these two. Infantry and anti-aircraft gun, and go 1, 2, and we will deposit them into Cairo. Oh, you know what? That's why I was moving that one guy over there. So let me ship that guy out. So there was three infantry that started in Egypt, and I was going to move one into Transjordan. There we go. So we're back up to three because we pulled that one from Malta. All right. I've got a destroyer down here in 71 that will come 1, 2, 3 up here with that transport in 81. My carrier will back out from 98 to 81. The destroyer will stay. And what have we up here in the Northland? We've got one of these fighters that has four movements. 1, 2, 3, 4 into Algeria. We have a bomber, which we'll use it as a transport. And I'll pull two guys off of London. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it would have two left. But I really can't get anywhere. So we're gonna leave it there in Algeria. The other two fighters in the English Channel will go back into London. We've got a anti-aircraft gun from Scotland coming down to London. This transport will move nobody, but we'll come over here to British Nova Scotia in C-Zone 106. And as I look around, I think that is it for merry old England. Putting all my stuff away. Just making sure. All right, that is golden. So let's place some units up in London. We've got five infantry and a fighter. And our other placements are down here in India, which will be two infantry and an artillery. All right, so let's look at some income. They are up to 41. And bonus-wise, what do we have here? We have those five, and we control Iraq, so we have two. We are not at war with Japan, so we don't have this other one. All right, so that is $7 plus that would be $48. So let's see, there's 45, 45, 3, $48. And obviously we're going to do our tech next turn. And that is where we are with Britain. Let's see where the units are. C-Zone 37 is a destroyer. You know, let's zoom in a little. Got that one right. Malaya, 3 British and 1 Commonwealth infantry. Shawn State, 2 infantry. Sea Zone 39, 1 battleship. Oh, no, that's a reminder to move the Commonwealth guy. India, 3 A&A aircraft guns, 1 airplane. I forget what's in the stack here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 infantry, 1 artillery. West India is 2 infantry, Sea Zone 80, 1 transport, 2 cruisers. Iraq, we have 1 artillery. Transjordan, 1 infantry, 1 fighter. Egypt is 3 infantry, 1 artillery, 1 anti-aircraft gun, 2 tacticals, 1 fighter. Anglo, Egypt, Sudan, 1 infantry. Tobruk, wipe out, so I got nothing. Malta, 1 fighter. Algeria, 1 fighter, 1 bomber, 1 or 2 infantry. And we scroll up here. Sea Zone 106 is a transport. Sea Zone 110 is a destroyer. And London, or England, I guess. Is it England? Yeah. It's just United Kingdom. In the London area is 5 infantry, 5 anti-aircraft guns, 1 mechanized, 3 fighters, 2 French infantry, a French fighter, and soon to be joined by 2 more Commonwealth infantry on their turn. And maybe some more from over there. Who knows? All right. That is it for Britain's turn. Thank you for watching. And we're heading back to Admiral Balk, I believe, is doing Italy as well as Germany. And that's correct. So they will be up next. Look for their turn soon.